Everybody, Nick here. I got a question over on one of our videos from Huzaifa Hussein. Huzaifa, I hope I'm pronouncing your name correctly, but this video was about how to put labels in your bar charts when you want to have a label in the base at the end of the bar and at the very outside end of the bar as well. So two labels, one bar. And we do this by kind of hacking or kind of doing a workaround behind the scenes with a clustered bar chart and then overlapping the bars 100%. But Huzaifa wanted to know if it was possible to have three columns of data and you only need to overlap two of them. I'm not exactly sure what you have in mind, Huzaifa, but let me see. I think this might be it. So I'm going to go over to that workbook that we made before. So I have another video that I'll link above and also below. This is how to create a clustered bar chart with multiple bars and indicator dots on top of those bars as well. And this comes from one single clustered bar chart with six columns of data right here. You can see 1.1, 2.2, 3, and .3. That's what this looks like right here. I'm going to use the same treatment, but we're going to do that same trick of labeling the bars both inside and outside. Okay, so go ahead and watch that video first, make this chart, and see if that gives you a little bit of inspiration. You'll learn how to click around and make this chart. I'm gonna go over here to this label right here. Now you see I already got rid of those dots because those dots actually come from error bars that we sort of rework and reformat in those bars. But this actual chart still has all six of these columns of data. And in this case, I've labeled them differently. So I'm gonna kind of look at for all my groups, group A, B, C, D. I have data for maybe pre and post and later post, or some kind of 3 points in time data here. Now this is made from six columns of data. I just inserted a clustered bar chart with all six of those columns and then formatted three of the columns, each of the bars that comes from the yellow highlighted columns, I just set to no fill so you can't see them, and I overlapped the bar. Now if your chart doesn't look exactly correctly when you overlap the bars, you might want to go up here to the chart design tab and see if that switch row and column button is activated. Go ahead and play with that and see if that reformats the bar chart exactly how you want it. But another way to look at this is if I go onto that chart design tab and I click on change chart type, you can see all of the different chart types that I have inside this chart. And you can actually see that this is just a clustered bar chart, but you can also see that I have these secondary axis buttons clicked. So for each of the columns that you want to overlap, you're going to have to make sure that those are set to the secondary axis. So three of my bars are on one axis, and then three of the bars are on the secondary axis, and then I overlap them completely. Again, go back to that original video and see how that is done. Now what we're going to do here is if I go over to the format chart area menu, click on the chart options drop down, that menu right here, and this will also tell you all the different series that we have access to in this chart. So right now you can see that I have my later post, post, and pre data right here. Those are in the three bars, the blue, orange, and green. But then I also have three additional series, the later post label, and pre label. Those are the bars that I set to no fill and I overlapped them. So now when I click on any of these things over here in the chart area menu, that will activate that bar in the chart. So you right here, you can see I activated the green bar, the later post data. But if I go ahead and activate the later post label data, then you can see that the Excel still gives me the little outline here indicating that it's selecting one of those bars. But since I set those to no fill, you can't see them, but they're still there. So when they're there like this, I'm going to go ahead and just right click, make sure that kind of clear series is still activated. We're going to right click, and we're gonna add label. So go ahead and add that label. It's gonna default to the data label on the outside of the bar, but I wanna put it on the inside of the bar. So go ahead and select those labels, go over to the Format Data Label tab, click on the bar chart icon under Label Position. You can see down here, label position, it's set to outside end. We want this to be inside base. So I'm going to click on inside base, and now you can see that label goes to the inside of the base. Now, I don't want the actual label, the actual number value for that data. So what I'm going to do under here, under label options, you can see value is selected. We're going to unselect value, and I'm going to go ahead and select series name. And that, you can see, gives me the later post data label. Now, what I'm going to do, you can see it's not wrapped wrapped, or it's actually wrapped onto two lines. If you want to unwrap those, just go over here to this little positioning, size and positioning icon there. And then right here, you can see wrap text in shape is always selected by default. Let's unselect that and see what happens. Now that stretches the label onto one single plane. Now, I don't want it to say later post label. If you wanted to click inside of here, you could go ahead and hard code it by typing in some text, but I want this to be a little bit more dynamic. So under the later post label column right here in my that yellow highlighted data, I'm just gonna go ahead and just label it later post. And now that changes the label. So let's go through this process again with the orange series of dots. That's the post label series that I have. So let's go back to, let's click in the chart. We'll activate the format series menu. Under series options right here, we're gonna click on post label right here, the series that says post label. Now you can see that sort of ghost, that sort of that behind the scenes bar is selected. Make sure that's selected, right click, and then add data labels. And we'll do the same thing. Click on those, go to the bar chart icon, let's put them inside base, unselect value, and select series name. And now again, I'm gonna go ahead into my data source and just say post, because I don't need that label. I just had that there so that I could kind of know behind the scenes which series was which. And now we'll do the same thing with our pre-data. So click in the chart to activate that, series options. Let's go to the pre-label. I'm gonna go ahead and right click. We'll put those labels inside the base, and then we'll unselect value and select series name. And again, I'm gonna update that in my source. All right, so now you actually don't need to have this legend on top because we've actually put the legend inside the chart, which is pretty cool. So let's go ahead and just delete that. That's a great way to directly label your legends inside your clustered bar charts. And if you only wanted two of these to show and you didn't want this third one to show, that's totally fine. All you have to do is go ahead and click that. You can see it clicks all of those options, and we can just delete those labels from the chart. Now, if you want to have all three of these at the top, but then you didn't want to have any of them on the bottom, all you need to do is isolate your data labels by double-clicking one of them. So when I click once, that's going to highlight all of the data labels from that series, but if I click on that one more time, it's going to isolate that label, and now I can do whatever I want with just that single label. So in this case, I'm just going to hit backspace and delete it. I'm going to do the same thing with this. The same thing with this one. And then, so then it's just a little bit of clicking there depending on how many clusters of bars you have. But I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure that all of them are gone. And now this is a really nice way to sort of embed your legend inside the chart with having labels there. And now if you wanted these labels on the end for the blue bars, for just that series one, that pre-data, just click on the actual blue bars if you want to. Click on add data label and then do the same thing there. And then do the same thing there. Awesome trick there. And if you're gonna directly label, you might not need to have those grid lines, and you might not need to have that legend there at the bottom. Really, really cool way to do this. I'm gonna go ahead and update this file into the template download that I have on Gumroad. So go ahead and download that if you like. The link will be down there in the comments. Otherwise, I hope this helps you in your effort to sort of hack Excel, bend it to your will to try and get these labels in the right positions, both inside the base and outside. So thanks again for watching. I had a great time making this video for you. If you like it, make sure to give it a thumbs up, click the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. Again, I hope you have a great day, and I hope this helps. See you next time.